So, as you guys know, you received a request for a letter, and right now, with the passage of Senate Bill 1, there's money out there for projects and a lot of grant funding opportunities. So the city is, the letter that you provided was actually the fourth grant funding opportunity in Senate Bill 1 that the city's been involved in the last year. So, but this one pertains to Imjin Parkway widening. And as you know, Imjin Parkway between Highway 1 and Reservation Road, from Highway 1 to Imjin Road, about halfway through it, is four lanes. And then the rest of it from Imjin Road to Reservation is two lanes. So it's a little bit of a bottleneck constraint on traffic, not only local but regional traffic. And currently over 23,000 average daily trips down. Definitely that's only going to increase. There's problems with commuters and congestion on Highway 68, and this is one of the other routes to get out to the peninsula between the peninsula and the valley. So this is a project that started a few years ago actually, and it takes a while to go through the development, programming, planning. Right now we're in the process of putting together the environmental document that gets circulated, published and circulated for public review and comment. The design itself is at about 65%. So, I'm going to say this current program funding for this is $35 million. And that's $20 million from Measure X, the TAMC's countywide 3/8% sales tax for transportation projects. And then $12 million is programmed for state transportation improvement program, state funding, and then $3 million for developer impact fees. All the development that's going on in Marina, and also there's regional impact fees for regional commuters. Every development has to pay their fair share of the trips that they generate and add to the roadway network. So those are collected when builders pull permits, and so we can plan for and fund the projects to accommodate the additional traffic. So I brought these boards, and some of you may not be able to see that well. Put some nice green flowers on the bottom here. And Stephen got to get the full experience of that because we were talking about what types of plants and features to put in the landscaping on these projects. But this is basic cross section as you're headed towards the ocean. You got two lanes in each direction. The lane widths are limited down to 11 feet wide. Typically you're seeing like 12 feet wide. Going to a little bit wider, we're trying to encourage a little bit slower speeds through the corridor because it is going to be a wider roadway. And we're planning on a 40 mile an hour speed limit through there. You'll think, well, we're going to slow down. We're not going to be able to get as many cars through there. But I'll show you how we're going to address that in some of the other boards. We got a median, about 8 foot median, for some native plants to infill eventually. We're not planning on planting them initially. Looking at ways to keep the project cost down. And over on the side, you'll see what looks like landscaped areas. But there's landscaping there, but that's actually how we're going to be treating the stormwater that runs off the roadway. We don't have a piping system to carry that to a percolation pond like we used to see in Marina, these lots that look like sinkholes around the city. The sand in Marina percolates really fast, and it's really good to work with that, and that's what these bioswales will do. The planting in there actually helps treat any pollutants that come off the road in the water, and then it will infiltrate down into the sand itself. We're accommodating bicycles in both directions, and with a 5 foot bike lane, and then there's a 3 foot striped buffer between the outside of the bike lane and the next travel lane for the cars. So a little bit of additional safety for the cyclists. And then for pedestrians and cyclists, there's actually a separated path for additional safety from the traffic, and that's going to be 8 foot wide with shoulders on it. kind of similar to what you see between Highway 1 and Engine Road. You'll see off to the south, there's that pathway. So if you've been in Reno long enough, you've seen roundabouts. And so this is how we're going to accommodate the traffic through there. And these will be the first multi-lane roundabouts in Marina. So there's two lanes coming through on the main direction on Imjun Parkway. And we're in the running with the city Salinas' Baranda Road project to try to get the first multi-lane roundabouts in the county on a major arterial. So this is going to be a little bit different. People will learn how to go through these as well. People feel a little bit uncomfortable initially until you figure out how to use them. But that's a good thing because people tend to approach them with a little bit more caution. But what you don't have here is stopping at traffic signals. You don't have the vehicles queuing up, waiting to go through. The traffic keeps flowing. So even though the overall speed on the roadway is slower, the travel time through the corridor, that section there is actually going to be in 2035. For an average commuter back and forth, it's going to be 45 seconds quicker than with the traffic signal. So.
Brian, is that, just my perspective, is that where the gas station and the little store is there? Or is it the gas station or the little store?
That's one of the intersections. There's actually going to be four roundabouts.
Oh.
At Preston Drive, Abrams Drive, that's where the store is. Mm-hmm. Where Marina Heights Drive, where the new Sea Haven development is going in. Mm-hmm. When they did the environmental for that and planned for the infrastructure, that was actually planned to be a traffic signal there. We're designing it to go in as a roundabout. And then the final one is at Imjun Road there. So every major intersection along the corridor will be a roundabout. Roundabouts have been shown to reduce accidents over traffic signals by almost 50%. And in urban settings, percentage of fatal accidents goes down 60% with roundabouts. So you don't have the T-bone crashes that you're seeing at intersections. The more side glancing blows are the types of accidents that do happen. So safer, they move traffic, and they're less maintenance as far as you don't have to go out and respond to call outs that a traffic signal's out or in flash. It's just basic passive features and that the drivers negotiate.
Can you explain how people use this inner
lane? So if you're coming in the two lanes, say you're coming in and you want to exit on this engine road here, if you're going to exit, you would want to be on the inside because you can see the inside lane will actually let you come out here. The third traffic are going to be, they can actually be in either lane, but the outside one will only go straight through. The inside one has the option of exiting or continuing around for the other exit. So, and there will be signage at the end as you're approaching the intersection. You've seen some of them where they'll have the two signs that show kind of if you're looking to take this exit, you want to be in the right lane. If you want to take these other exits, you want to be in the left lane. This is just a show of cross-section of what the roundabout could look like if it had some trees in there. You can see this is actually a pretty big roundabout. One of the biggest concerns that we hear from residents on the roundabouts in Marina is, if you put trees there, I can't see across the intersection. Well, this roundabout is so big, you're not going to be looking at stuff across the intersection anyway. You're going to be looking at the stuff coming from the left. So we're looking at some trees growing in eventually there, and then some artwork at each of the roundabouts, and we're looking at possible themes that represent the area, so you can associate a certain theme with the roundabout, and maybe help give people directions if anybody ever does that anymore. Advertising for bids early 2019 with construction starting that summer, maybe late summer 2019 with a two-year construction period. So there's going to be a bit of construction to deal with during it, but know, we really need to get it in sooner rather than later as the traffic continues to grow. Is anything else on
that? Yes, the roundabout going to be a phase two project, or is it going to be all inclusive with the construction? In other words, are you going to widen it and then do the roundabout?
It's going to be, I don't know if you've, I get to Gilroy quite a bit, so I've seen them construct a lot of these roundabouts that they're building up there. And they'll actually build about half the roundabout, and then they'll flip traffic over and build the other half. So it'll be part of the widening, you know, they'll be doing the roundabouts at the same time, and then they'll shift the traffic over, and there'll probably be more than two shifts in there to get the roundabouts completely constructed. But and they also did the same thing up at, the 8th Avenue and Inner Garrison when they did that roundabout.
Same with Beach and Del Monte.
We don't really have the option of routing the traffic far enough around to build a full roundabout and then bring the traffic back over. So it's like you'll see the puzzle kind of coming together in pieces, and then when we flip it over, it's done.
But is that land to the right, west of MGN, is that developable land, or is that still part of Fort Ord between, I guess it's like Abram and between that shell and over there by the where the school starts again, like Engine Road?
So kind of, I'll see the south, as you're heading west,
right? Yeah.
It's on the
yeah,
left?
South side, yeah.
You're heading, so that's actually county land now, and at some point may become city land, but in that land is where the landfill was for the Fort Ord, the military base.
Oh, okay.
And it is part of the Army Superfund site, so there's still a lot of cleanup that they're responsible for in there. So it's going to be kind of limited as to how much and when that land would actually be available for development. So you'll probably see that open space for quite a while.
Based on the economy.
Yeah.
Okay, cool, thanks.
Talking about city county, the East Garrison complex is county, but they're 933. And the people who are calling AT&T or something, they give them their tip card and they say, no, you're a marina. No, I'm in East Garrison. So as they build out, county's going to be like an island in the middle of the city almost.
Kind of like Delray Oak, same thing.
Yeah.
They're 93940 Monterey, but they're Delray Oak, they have their own.
The only question I have, Brian, you're going to widen in Engine Road, and already they're backed up at one. What are you going to accomplish by expediting traffic only to sit longer at Second Street?
Well, we do have some projects, some more intact projects that we need to get back into design for the rest of the corridor west of Engine Road, for the part that's already widened four lanes. There needs to be some improvements at California. That's already a poor level of service during the commuting hours. And so work to be done there, work at 3rd Avenue. The biggest bottleneck is the actual bridge. And getting on to Highway 1. And so that's Caltrans. Right now the bridge is, the width of the bridge, Caltrans in the past has told us it's too narrow, you can't go to
four lanes.
You can't go to four lanes on there or more lanes on that bridge. So we'll continue to have that conversation with them. When we did the intersection improvements there this last year, we removed that connection to the Bay Trail at that intersection. One of the concerns was cyclists being on that roadway. The other thing is that work in Highway 1 is constrained by the California Coastal Commission and permitting widening or impacts within that coastal zone. So in addition to getting more lanes on the bridge, you also have to have more lanes on the ramp to get onto the highway. So there's some definite regulatory agency hurdles that need to be overcome with that. And it's not Engine Parkway, but one of the grants that we're putting in tomorrow is for a planning grant for the Del Monte Avenue extension down to 2nd Avenue. that's been on the city's plans for quite a few years. And we want to see if we can go after some of the Senate Bill 1 funding for planning and design of that and move that forward sooner rather than later. Because some of that traffic on that intersection with Imogen Parkway and Highway 1 is really Marina residents trying to get to north part of Marina from right. south or vice versa. So having that connection parallel to the highway is going to relieve some of that traffic actually going through that interchange on the highway. And that's the reason Caltrans actually approached us and said, hey, we know you've been trying to get this project through, and we think it's a good candidate for this planning grant. So applying for that grant.
Hey, Brian, so is the idea on that that there would be an extension to 2nd Avenue to Del Monte, and it would cut on the west side of the high school?
Yes. So Patton Parkway would extend up to that extension as well to the intersect there. So
right.
You'd have better access for the high school and then north-south access.
Yeah. Which will solve the pedestrian and bike issue that's going on right now, because now to get to the new strip mall, right, on bike or foot, you have to go down the bike path, pass it, go under a tunnel, and then come back up.
Yeah.
They don't want you going over that little barrier and going over the bridge because it's dangerous, you know.
Just one last question, Brian. There was a comment in the past about making a bypass from reservation to bike riders. Have you heard about that?
There's been work at Afora. They've been doing some workshops and outreach on that. You know, they've developed some alternatives. There's been opposition to those alternatives. So they're, you know, procedurally they were challenged on some of the environmental process, but they're revitalizing that and trying to move that forward again. So I'd encourage you to stay in touch with the kind of their agendas and stuff that they're bringing forward on that Eastside Parkway. Bora is taking the lead on the planning at this point, yes.
Thank you. Any other questions for us? Okay.
I'll be here.
Thanks, Brian. Thank you, Brian.